हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू श्रीज ओनली नरिशिंग फिश नर्चरिंग लाइफ एजुकेशनल यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट इज द फीचर्स ऑफ प्लास्टिलोस्टोमी। इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज ऑस्टिक फिश इन कॉमनली नोन एज द बोनी फिश। सो लेट्स गो। Plastiliostomy means, tilios means complete and stomy means the mouth, that is complete mouth fishes are called as a tiliostomy. Osteichthyes, it is also called as osteichthyes or commonly known as the bony fishes. Now we will see the characters of this class. It is the largest class of vertebrate and more than 29,000 species of bony fishes found in freshwater as well as marine environment. That is, it is the largest class of vertebrate, that is number of species is more, comes under this, that is more than 29,000 species come under this class from the marine as well as the freshwater environment. Mostly these fishes come from the freshwater environment. Now we will see the characters. First character, that is tiliostomy, is also called as a bony fishes or osteichthyes. As we see, the endoskeleton is made up of bones, that is called as a bony fishes. Second character is, these are highly advanced group of fishes, that is the brain of these fishes are small in relation to the body size. Means these are the advanced brains present in these fishes as compared to the elasmobranchia and other fishes. The brain size is small, but the capacity of brain to work is higher, that is called as an advanced group of the fishes. Third character is large number of bony fishes lives in freshwater. That is, a large number of bony fishes comes from the freshwater environment. It is also called as the freshwater fishes, but is not true. It is also marine environment fishes also. Fourth character is the endoskeleton. Endoskeleton is nothing but the skull, vertebral column, pectoral fin and pelvic girdle are comes under this endoskeleton, and it is made up of thin form of bones. This endoskeleton is made up of thin form of bones. Fifth characters, these fishes flourished during Devonian period. Devonian period is also called as the age of fishes. Now next character, that is sixth character, perfect mouth fishes. As we will already tell, tiliostomy means, that is perfect mouth fishes. In these fishes, the mouth is completely developed, that's why called perfect mouth fishes. These fishes primarily upper and lower jaws are suspended by addition of membrane bone, which form the secondary jaws. These are the perfect mouth fishes. Now we will see the next, that is seventh character. The body of these fishes is generally covered with an exoskeleton in form of rhombic or cycloid or spinoid scales. Here we can see the body is covered with the scales. Scales are of rhombic type or cycloid or spinoid type, and this is nothing but the exoskeleton, that is the skeleton which is present outside the body in the form of scales. It is called as exoskeleton, and it is made up of rhombic or cycloid or spinoid type of scales. Eighth character, single external branchial aperture is present, which is called as operculum. Here clearly you can see here this gill covering, that is single aperture, which is called as operculum. It is nothing but the protective covering of the gills. While respiration, fish inhale the water from the mouth and exhale from this aperture, that is aperture in between below the operculum, through moving the water on gills. This is called as operculum. It is present in the bony fishes. There is no cloaca being separate and anal
And urogenital aperture.
Cloaca is a chamber where the genital as well as urinary ducts are open in this chamber. That's called cloaca, but there is no cloaca in this species. We can clearly observe from here. Next character is claspers, or male capillary organs are absent in this species. Clasper is nothing but the male copulatory organ which helps to transfer the sperms in the female body. That's why it is called as a secondary sexual character, which is absent in this species. That is why the mostly the bony oviparity, that is fertilization, may be external type, that is eggs and sperms fertilize outside the body of the female, that is most in the environment. Now we will see the 11th character, air bladder. It is also called as the swim bladder because it helps in the swimming for the fishes. That is why called as a swim bladder. It is usually present in this species. The bony fishes, in bony fishes, these air bladders are present. Next character is the spiracles are absent. Spiracle is nothing but the branchial aperture. First branchial aperture mostly present in the elasmobranchial fishes. We can see clearly seen in whale fish, that is spiracle. It is 13th character is a spiral valve, is absent in intestine of this species. This spiral valve mostly present in the intestine, in the digestive system of the elasmobranchial, and here in bony fishes or teleostomic fishes it is absent. Now next character is a freshwater fishes retain high concentration of ammonia in urine, hence it is called as a aminophilic animals, because the concentration of ammonia in the urine due to the osmoregulation process is high. That's why these fishes are also called as aminophilic animals. Now we will see the next character, that is 15th character. Both oviparity and ovoviviparity is seen in this species. Oviparity means which species lays their eggs in the environment, that is called as oviparity, that is egg laying fishes. Egg giving fishes are called as oviparity fishes, while ovoviviparity fishes is the fishes which give the birth to their young ones, but there is no placental connection between mother and offsprings or developing embryo. Means the embryo gets developed through taking nourishment from the yolk only, but the development is complete the inside the body of the female. That's why it is called as oviparity. Fertilization is external, that is the outside of the female body and in the water medium. That's we can see there mostly the there is no copulatory organ. They lay eggs. After laying eggs by the female, the it gave fertilized by the laying the sperms on these egg outside the body of the female in the environment. That is, it may be marine or freshwater environment. That is, the fertilization mostly is external in these fishes. Now, 7th character, kidney in teleostomy fishes are mesonephric type. Mesonephric type nephrons are present in the kidney of teleostomy fishes. That is why this kidney is called as a mesonephric kidney. Now, we will see the 18th character near about the tail. Tail is here, you can see this one is a tail which is called as a caudal fin. And tail of bony fishes is a both homocercal as well as heterocercal. You can see here, this is a tail or caudal fin is homocercal type. Homocercal means that is the upper lobe of the caudal fin and lower lobe of the caudal fin are equal in size, with the end of the vertebral column also on both sides. That's why this caudal fin is called as homocercal. Homo means same, equal. 19th character, there is 4 to 5 pairs of gill slits are present. clearly you can observe here, this is upper colon and inside it, there is a gill slits are present and it varies from 4 to 5 pairs on each side. That is, each side contain 4 to 5 gill slits. Now we see the examples, that is Katla, Rohu, Carp are the example of the bony fishes which is come from the freshwater environment, while mackerel and other bony fishes come from the marine environment. Thus friends, we learn about the general characteristics or features of the class Teleostomi, that is the osteichthyes fishes, which is commonly known as bony fishes. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.